So today we're going to talk about CSS. CSS, or Cascading Style Sheets, is a language used to specify how web page elements should be rendered in a browser. So CSS is a separate language from HTML, but the two languages are complementary to each other. HTML code specifies the content of each web page element, and CSS code indicates how that content should be displayed. So I always like to think of it as the fun or fancy part of the web development programming. Because CSS is a separate language, it does use its own syntax. So it's different code. A lot of similarities, but definitely different. You create CSS code for an HTML document by writing style rules, which are lines of or blocks of CSS code that specify the presentation of web page elements. The most recent version of CSS is known as CSS 3. So you guessed it, there was a 1 and a 2, and now there's a 3. While CSS 3 supports some features not available in previous versions, it uses the same syntax as the previous versions. So let's take a look at what CSS looks like. So let's say I have a paragraph that I want to design. Let's say I want to center it and make the background of that paragraph a different color. So for CSS, first we have our selector. What am I styling? And that's the P for paragraph. So I typed the P there. Then we do a space, and then we do a curly bracket. So different than the HTML brackets, this is curly. Think of style curly. Now I'm using, in this specific example, I'm using a program called Brackets, but Notepad++, Visual Studio Code, Aptana, any of those text editors out there will work. Once I typed in the bracket, it did automatically add the closing one, like a lot of text editors do. But I want to go ahead and crack that open. I'm going to hit enter so that I can type the rules or declarations that I want to assign to this paragraph. I'm going to space 3 times so that I'm within the bracket from a visual perspective. It's easier to look at your code later when you put in extra spaces so that there's a hierarchy to it. Easier to find stuff. So I'm going to text align. Helps if I spell that right. Text align, colon, space, center. And it's important. End with a semicolon. Every declaration ends with a semicolon. And since I want to do more to this paragraph, I stay within the curly brackets here, because we're going to put all our declarations between the brackets. And then let's go ahead and apply a background color. So I'm going to go background hyphen color colon space. And let's go with blue. And then a semicolon. And then of course, if your text editor doesn't already do so, make sure you add that closing bracket. The closing bracket does align with the P. And there we go. There is our first style rule. So again, the P here is the selector. The items here in the center are the declarations. What are we declaring to be done? And every declaration is separated with a semicolon. And finally, your style rule is closed with a curly bracket. Now, a little bit about CSS properties and values. The background color affects an element's fill color. So what's the text behind it? Or what is the color behind the text? Color is an element's foreground color. For elements containing text, it's the text color. So if I just said color colon blue, then the text color would have been blue. And text align, we're just telling it whether it's left, right, center, or justify. Now, colors, you can type in most of them. There are quite a few options out there, but I encourage you to pull up your browser. I love using Chrome, so I'm just going to go to Chrome and type in HTML color codes or charts or picker. There's so many out there. Again, we always skip the ads, go to the one towards the top. And then this is an HTML color codes. And this way, you can find the exact color you want. And if you click on it, it will give you what's called a hex number here. So I could use this number. So let's say I want blue, but I want a darker blue like this one. I can go ahead and copy the hex code, and in my brackets here, instead of putting this blue, I can paste that hex code, and it will apply that specific blue color to my background. So now that we have our first style rule created, let's embed it into our HTML document, otherwise known as an embedded style sheet, and watch it have an effect on our HTML code, aka our website. So I'm going to grab this language here, and I'm going to copy it. So Control C or Command C. And then I'm going to open up Aptana Studio 3 and get into the document we were playing with in the previous video. It says Hello World. And I did add a couple extra characters. I added the header here for semantic reasons, identifying the header. And then I added a footer with a paragraph element saying designed by Melody Chronister. So that way we have two paragraphs. We'll see what happens when we add this style rule. Before we add it, let's see what this looks like without any style. So we can click this green arrow here to run. And that's what it looks like presently in the browser. Black, white, boring, right? So let's see what this does. Let's get back into Aptana. So I'm going to take that code I copied, and the CSS as an embedded style sheet always goes in the head. I'm above the closing head bracket. I'm going to go ahead and do a bracket and then the word style. Close that bracket. It automatically adds my closing bracket there. Hit enter to open it, and then I'm going to paste the style rule I just wrote. I'm going to go ahead and just put the indentation so that this is easier to read. And now that I have it indented just as I would like it, we see that it is incorporated within our head, and we're going to go ahead and save it. So I'm going to go to File, Save, and then let's try to run it again and see what happens. And ta-da! It's hard to see, of course, because we did a blue background and the black text. This would not be an accessible website. And so let's go in and change it. Instead of background color, let's change it to text color, huh? So up here where it says background color, I'm going to just delete the word background and just leave it as the word color, and then save again. File, save. And then let's run it again. Oh, much better. So it says, this is my awesome website designed by Melody Chronister, and it centers it. Now, you notice that it applied it to both, and that's simply because we said that every paragraph element has this style. But I want to have it only have the text that says, this is my awesome website, blue. I don't want the designed by Melody Chronister to be blue. That's where the classes come in. So you notice, remember here in a previous video, I typed in the word class equals test. So if we want to assign a style to a class, instead of this P up here, we're going to delete that and put a dot and then put the word test. And that tells it to look for the class with the word of test. That's what that period means. And then let's save it again. File, save. And let's try to run it again. And ta-da! So now we see the text, this is my awesome website, centered in blue, and we see the footer black and its traditional left. One last thing that I'll play with here, just to give you ample example. Let's say I'd rather have the footer blue and centered. I'm going to just take out this class down here, and I'm going to apply it to this paragraph instead. I'm going to save that, run it once more, and now the footer is designed by Melody Chronister, blue and centered. And that's just a glimpse of using CSS to style documents, because let's face it, we like to give our website our own flair by selecting fonts that we find visually attractive. So in the next video, we will talk about creating an external style sheet. So I hope that you enjoyed your first glimpse at CSS.